Good morning and welcome to everyone out on the internet joining us through the webinar and everybody in the room. I'm Denise Peach and I'm the chief of the CVAS branch here at the California Department of Aging. So we have a big group to get started, a lot of work to get started on today for this quality work group for CVAS, developing the quality strategy. So what we'll start with is some introductions or sort of a roll call. If we can go over who's on the webinar, and I think we have the lines open to let you announce yourselves, and then you can also make sure that we do sort of a sound check at the same time. So let us know that you're out there. So you want to call?
Sure. We have Amanda Carruthers on the line.
Amanda, you want to say hi? We know you're there. Okay, so some of you may or may not have microphone capabilities, but we're going to leave the mics open for you, and you can put your phones on mute so we don't have any static or anything, but you can join in the conversation as you are able.
Okay. Next is Burge Karak. Forgive me for mispronouncing it.
Burge, are you out there? Okay, so we're working on a pin there. Okay, go ahead.
Deb Toews.
Deb Toews from Anthem, right? Okay, Deb, if you're able to. Yay! Hi, Deb. Welcome.
Good morning.
Anybody else?
Gretchen Brixen.
Gretchen?
She also needs to enter.
Gretchen, you need to enter your PIN. But we know you're there.
Arena?
Arena?
Good morning.
Good morning. Welcome.
James Kawakami.
James?
Yeah, I'm here.
Welcome, James.
Okay. All right.
And Min Cole.
Min? Okay, so that's great. For a quick roll call, we have a couple of plans that are on the line, and we have a few providers that are on the line, and then we'll go around the room and introduce ourselves here, if we will. Let's start with you, Jill.
Hi, good morning. I'm Jill Sparrow, one of the managers in the CVAS unit.
I'm Eden Rosales, the manager in the CVAS unit.
I'm Mark Koval, the administrator of Vermont Grants CVAS in Oxnard.
I'm Irene Kovalik, executive director of Vermont Grants in Oxnard.
Lydia Missalides, executive director, California Association for Adult Day Services.
Lois Stones, program director at Elder Day in Santa Cruz.
Sabrina Younger, health program specialist with DHCS.
Sana Meyer, policy and medical monitoring branch chief with DHCS, and I oversee some of the managed care plans and the quality improvement efforts there.
Hi, I'm Lynn Benjamin, health program specialist with the CVAS branch, and we're going to encourage everyone to speak up so that
So I'm going to go through some housekeeping now. Welcome, everybody. Also in the back of the room, especially for those of you on the line, actually back of the room and the front of the room, we have Adam Smith, who's our data guy, web guru, who will help you with any kind of webinar challenges that you may be having. Type something in if you're having some issues and he'll help you out. And Jill Sparrow in the front of the room is going to be taking your comments from people on the line. And we definitely want to encourage your participation. Happy that you're joining us on the line if you couldn't make it to see us in person, but definitely participate. Want you to participate by speaking up, raising your hand, raising your voice, or typing in a note, and we'll share what it is that you have to say. So with that in mind, a couple more housekeeping items. If you're having trouble hearing us on the web, just on the internet, let us know. And for those of you in the room, we have a hall pass. If you need to use the facilities, we have a cafeteria downstairs, and we have the facilities down the hall, the restrooms, so you can use the pass to get in and out of the door or borrow one of ours. We'll take a break if everybody needs one. Just give me the universal break sign, and we'll take a few minutes to just take care of necessities. But if not, I think that we're going to try to get right through it because we have a lot to get through today. All right, so thank you. Let's start at the top. You all have an agenda, everybody in the room, and did we send the agenda to people online?
No.
Okay, so people online don't have it, so we'll pop it up on the screen so you can see it on your screens. So here's what we're doing here. We have a charter and a purpose. The purpose is up on the top of the agenda. The quality work group is to develop a quality assurance and improvement strategy to promote person-centered planning and delivery of quality services in the CVAS setting. And there will be overlapping areas of focus between between the CBAS quality and IBC revision groups. So, together we're going to work on these. We have two work groups meeting today. Some of you in the room and online will be participating in both groups, the morning and afternoon. This morning is quality, in the afternoon we're doing the individual plan of care revision. So there's overlapping issues there. And so that's what we're charged with doing. As far as today goes, I think our objective for today is to actually start throwing some ideas against the wall. We've been talking for the last two meetings in October and in December about quality, what it means in the context of the managed care plans and what it is they're looking for, in the context of other DHCS mandates and plans, in the context of the waiver. So we've been talking about a lot of things and generating ideas, and this meeting we hope to show you some of the draft list of some of these preliminary initiatives that we might undertake and build into our written strategy, and see what y'all think. Maybe get some preliminary buy-in on some direction, because it's our hope that between now and July, where we're going to have two more meetings, one in April, one in June, that we will have a strategy written and together, that we all have some consensus around, and that we begin the process of implementing. So that's kind of where we're headed. So objectives for today are pretty straightforward, that we want to look at some possible efforts and measures and start getting some agreement from everyone. You know, we throw some things out, we add some things in, or modify some of the things that we've been coming up with. Okay, so that's our objectives for this morning and our introductions, but we got one more introduction because somebody came in, and I think we're going to have more people sort of coming in to the meeting, and we're glad to have you.
Thank you.
Introduce yourself.
And I'm Ruth Gay. I'm the Director of Policy for the Northern California Northern Alzheimer's Association.
Welcome. Thanks for joining us, Ruth.
And a couple other people joined us on the webinar, Maureen Dunn and Daisy Epsilon.
Okay. Maureen and Daisy, welcome. Both providers, Maureen from Mills Peninsula and Daisy from Eschaton. You guys want to say hello, if you can?
Maureen needs to interrupt.
Maureen, you need a pin, and Daisy, you should be able to open your lines open. Okay, well, good morning and welcome. Glad you're there anyways. And you just yell out whenever it is you want to talk and type things in, and we'll try to address your concerns. We definitely want the people on the line to participate. That's why you're here. No ride-alongs. Nobody gets to just listen in and hang out and spy on what we're doing. You actually have to roll up your sleeves and work with the rest of us. So definitely want to hear from all of you. Okay then, anything else in the way of overview? Somebody else? Yeah, okay, good. I'm encouraging everybody to chime in today. I usually end this day with a complete exhaustion because I talk all day, and I know you guys need a break from hearing my voice too, so I'm going to try to facilitate all of you, so jump in. So a little quick little review again, if we could, Jill, just pop up the charter. Not the one that's on the internet. We've actually had some more people join our work group efforts. So we just want to sort of show you on our charter, which is there we go. And just again, the charter has remained the same. There it is, that we're going to develop a quality assurance and improvement strategy, including metrics for the tracking and improving of participant outcomes and the quality of care delivered by CBAS providers. So a CBAS specific quality plan that further elaborates many of the other plans and documents and rules that we're subject to. And then there's the list of members. We've been adding people as you know. You want to add who we tell us who we've added?
We have a new participant, new member, Min Cole. So
okay, Min Cole from RICON.
The charter hasn't changed, it's just the member.
Yeah, everything else has remained on the charter, so we continue to just want to update you to who's been participating in these conversations. And also at the table today, Mark and Irene Kovalik, who joined us. So I don't know if you're officially on this meeting, but you're here for the IBC for sure this afternoon, but you're going to join us for quality, which of course we're wanting to make sure that we have as inclusive a process as possible, because we need everybody's voices, because otherwise, as I said to Lois when she was coming in, we just have to make it up if you guys don't participate. So we definitely want to hear you guys, your voices on this. Okay, so that's the charter, and again, we're constantly bringing new items up, new versions of this up on our website. Let's take a look really quickly by way of review at our December meeting and some of our action items that we've been working on since we last saw you in December. We've had a busy month here, busy 2 months. And so Lynn, if you want to run us through some of the things that we have that we've been doing.
Yeah, the status has been updated since our December meeting. So we have posted the Department of Healthcare Services All Plan Letter 15023 on the CVAS Facility Site Review Tool. Oksana discussed that tool at a previous meeting, so that has been posted and distributed to our CVAS Center and through an All Center letter as well. We talked about health risk assessments, and we've identified that we're going to continue to talk about health risk assessments through the work group meetings, because it's relevant with everything we're talking about, and to explore ways to use and encourage CVAS centers to assist managed care plans in completing their health risk assessments for their members. Develop the quality strategy report. We've made progress on that. We have on the framework itself, which was our outline, and we did add CADS to the framework's list of national and state organizations involved in quality activities. And this draft strategy report post-December meeting has been posted. However, we've updated it. We'll talk about it today. Complete the draft quality strategy work tool. Again, we've done more work on it. We did post the original framework, but or work tool, but we've added more to it, which we'll discuss today. We were going to request and did of DHCS data on the percent of CVAS participants in CalMediConnect and managed long-term services and support. So we requested that data. We've not yet received it. We've identified that we want to keep informed on what's happening at the national level with the National Adult Day Services Association, NADSA, as well as what CADS is doing related to quality. And so we're going to take the lead from Lydia when there's something more new to report that you want us to know. So that's kind of an ongoing potential agenda item. We are going to talk about the EQRO HASAG focus study and the status of that. Oksana is going to give us an update on where we are and what the plan is to begin a focus study for CVAS. We'll continue to discuss core quality measures at future meetings. That's
kind of ongoing.
Ongoing. Mm-hmm. We did identify that we want to stay informed or be informed about what ADHCs are doing in other states related to quality. We've not really explored that, but that's on our list to do. Number 18, it was recommended that we take a look at the Nursing Home Compare website, where they are making transparent a quality identification system for nursing homes using a 5-star rating system. So we've got the link here, but we've not really talked about it, but it's something for us to look at as a model for how we measure quality and how we make it public and transparent for CVAS centers. And then we determined our February meeting for today, and on our agenda we've proposed dates for our April and June meeting that we want to finalize early so that people can put a hold on their calendar.
Great, thank you, Lynn.
Bird want to know the link documents you should be accessing right now.
So a question from somebody on the webinar about those documents that you should be accessing. So we have posted our action items and minutes, yes, on our website.
Yeah, our next item on the agenda is to look at the website to show.
Okay,
what
great. Yeah, so let's review that. Thank you
for the reminder.
Okay, so we're going to take a look at that now, Virge. Thank you. We're going to show you up on the website what we have posted since our last meeting, because in between meetings, this is always our task to go to the internet. Yeah. Website. It's always our task to get things posted, so because we're trying to run as transparent a process as possible and as inclusive a process as possible. So just to review, here's where you want to go if you want to access documents on work group activities on our website. If you scroll down to the second bar for HCD settings, Jill. So if you scroll down to the bottom bar, second bar right there, HCD settings. You're going to click on that bar. For those of you at home, go ahead and try this, and scroll down again, and you're going to go to work groups, and from there you're going to go to wherever it is you'd like to go. There's a meetings page, and where we have things posted by meetings, and then this is the documents page, where we have various documents for for the work group activities. So we have the charters, we have various work tools that we've got in play, and then background and reference materials, lots and lots of reference materials on quality and on the individual plan of care. And we've got some website links that take you out to places that if you're interested in really being an A student in looking into other links around quality planning on the national and state level. And then some policy, laws, regulations, waiver requirements that are good references. So these are the pages where you have all kinds of material to look into work group activities, and then their meeting pages if you back up to get specifically to Burge's question, where we have on the meetings, you can click on each of the meetings, it'll have posted what we have used for the meetings. So you're going to go back out and then go into work groups, and then there you go, meetings. Okay, so there's our meetings and the information there.
Do we want to just click on one so they can see the subheadings under meetings in terms of what's posted related to each?
Sure, go to the December meeting. Yeah, that's great. And then you can see that there's agendas, there's webinar recordings, so if you miss something and you want to go back and listen to it, and meeting summary information. So again, lots of places that everybody can look at, but for the work group members in particular, you can track what's been going on. Okay? Let's see, next step on our agenda is that we're going to have an update on the Health Services Advisory Group focus study. So in past meetings, we have talked about the fact that the Department of Healthcare Services has responsibilities under its, I think it's under the 1115 waiver with the feds, to have something known as an ECRO. And help me out, Oksana. And tell us about the ECRO and HSAG and what it is that you guys are required to do and how this relates to CBAS and our status with that.
Okay, so thank you. Just very quickly, by way of background, so we are federally mandated to have an external quality review organization, which is an independent kind of quality review, you know, contractor to go out and review the performance of our health plans. And so health plans on an annual basis report on a set of metrics that are HEDIS measures. They report, you know, up to NCQA and also to our ECRO, and the ECRO audits the rates to make sure that the rates are actually valid and are usable. And so we use the ECRO to basically validate the plan performance and kind of track quality kind of over time and by plan and by region and by county. So what we have with our focus study, so this is an option under our new contract with the ECRO, and so we had the opportunity to do kind of a number of offshoots. So the ECRO is federally mandated to do a certain kind of just standard deliverables for us. So they do the validation, they do technical assistance with the health plans. And so under our new contract with the ECRO, we had the opportunity to do kind of a deeper dive into certain topics. And so one of the ideas we had, along with our colleague at the long-term care division, Rebecca Shoup, she's the division chief over there, was to do a deeper dive on CBAS. And so because CBAS has now been carved into managed care, we kind of wanted to see, well, you know, what does the data show? And so in June, we are going to receive, for the first time ever, essentially patient-level information from all of the plans. And so what we had asked our ECRO to do was to tell the plans to flag all of the numbers that are in CBAS. And so we were really excited to do kind of get a deeper look and kind of a wider perspective as to what can we see with the data. And so that's kind of the general overview. And so when we started talking, so what's going to happen in June is we're going to get kind of this massive amounts of patient level information from everybody who's been in CBAS across all the plans. And so what we want to do is figure out what does the data show us. What we've had several discussions with our ECRO to do some kind of a preliminary analysis or kind of preliminary planning as to, well, can we, you know, establish rates for these specific folks individually and compare them to kind of Medi-Cal rates or rates for, we do separate rates for seniors and persons with disabilities. So So there's been some conversations around there, but what we're a little bit stumped because we don't know what the data is going to look like. And so at this point in time, we're going to wait until about June to take a look at the data, see what we can do, see what kind of other linkages we could do with data that you guys have at CDA, see what we have in our data warehouse at DHCS to see, you know, what are some of the conclusions and findings that we can draw out of the data. So that's kind of where we are. It's kind of a new territory for us, and we're excited about it, and we'll see what the data shows. And we'll definitely have more conversations with the department.
Great, thank you. Yeah. Lydia?
So it's all claims data only?
No, it's patient-level performance. So, for example, for a diabetic measure, we measure diabetes. So, for example, you'll have John Doe, who was a member of CVAS, let's say, in a plan. So we're going to get, in June, we're going to get, you know, John Doe. Did John Doe have a diabetic screen? So we're going to get that information.
So, Oksana, what I'm puzzled about is that 80%, I think, is that the number?
Yeah, well, that's the number we're trying to determine, but yeah, it's
right.
Not 80%.
So how do the plans have patient-level data when they're not responsible for their
health? So it's for the plans that have the responsibility.
But even the plans who have responsibility, unless somebody's in CalMediConnect as of whenever it rolled out in that county, there's still not going to be any data.
So there will be data, but it's going to be a smaller number of folks.
It's going to be very small, because I think our uptake's only 5%
in CalMediConnect. That's exactly kind of one of the...
So then we have to figure out if that's a representative group of the whole 80, 95%.
Exactly.
So we have, through a project we did with our consultant, obtained claims data from about 3 or 4 plans. Mm-hmm. There were a lot of problems with data integrity and the way it was sorted and so on and so forth. So we zeroed in on one plan right now. It might be instructive to, and you're going to have claims data as well?
We do have claims. Well, again,
on this upload you're going to get?
Again, if, like you said, if the plan is responsible for that member's care, we would have their claims and their encounter information in our data warehouse. So we know, unless they're fee-for-service, you know, that's a little bit different. What we see in managed care is we would have their encounters. And so
you'll have that for everybody, except for the few hundred that are fee-for-service. You'll have claims data for everyone.
For those.
But you're not going to have medical information for
so
everybody.
So for the no. people that the plans are responsible for their health care, we would have their encounter data. So again,
it's a small number,
that's exactly kind of, we were really excited about this opportunity. And as we began to dig a little bit deeper,
So is there no crosswalk right now between Medicare data sets and the Medi-Cal data sets we have in California? I thought there was some efforts to bring those two together so you could.
I know that at this point in time for like my folks, my researchers in my division, it's really difficult to get a hold of the Medicare data because we're not really the owners of that. I know we've had some conversations with our long-term care folks, and so they have access to Medicare data. So we've been doing some analysis actually specifically on some of the CalMediConnect But it would be interesting. It would be interesting to see what you guys have with what you have done with the 3 plans, or particularly
We should connect up and we can.
Yeah, that would
maybe
be good for us.
Help us noodle it through.
So, and Lydia, you remember from the past meeting, we had sort of been thinking that we were going to start in February, and then we pushed this thing back, and I think clearly we will know more after we have a couple more of our meetings too, and then having an opportunity to sit down with the Health Services Advisory Group, who is the ECRO, and tell them exactly what we have. Because this is where we left it, Oksana, we talked last, is that we wanted to talk about merging other data warehouse information from DHCS alongside of Encounter, alongside of the plan performance, alongside of possibly some CDA data, and picking a few data.
Yeah, I think it would be great to have
to compare
that map, and then...
Yeah.
present it and see kind of what, how they react to it and see what's doable and
right.
You know, some of those.
Right.
Okay. Yeah. Thank you. Just a comment question. I know we kind of talked last time too about like what kind of data might be available and what kind hadn't been thought about and if we could tease out other data. Mm-hmm. And I guess one question I had was, since we're talking about many population and especially those counties that are moving forward with the coordinated care initiative, would we be able to pull out, like some of those are part of a grant to provide better managed care for people with Alzheimer's disease in particular, using CBAS and other service settings. Is there, you know, because I remember us saying Alzheimer's by itself wasn't easy to pull out, but can we pull out some of that kind of data where they participated in looking at improvements in care and services and cost savings?
By plan.
Yeah. Or by disease?
Yeah.
Maybe by disease. I don't know if there's like certain specific ICD-9 code or ICD-10 codes or something.
There are could, for Alzheimer's.
I certainly, you know, put it on paper and we can see what we can do with it.
And I think that, Ruth, that kind of gets to this question that we had when we were talking about this before, which is what's the interesting question we want to ask? What is it we want the data to tell us? I think we still haven't quite crafted that, but we might get closer again after a couple more meetings of this group. So.
Well, and just to add to that, I think, you know, one of the things that the plans are really being measured on, and it's always under question, is does this really save money?
Yeah.
And that's what the state often is interested in. That's what we really want to get at. So if we could get at some data that showed that it prevented you know, and that's always the hard stuff to get any quality information about.
Yeah, it's the triple aim stuff.
Yeah.
The cost, the experience.
Yeah. But we're measured on it,
yeah.
Right? The plans are measured on it.
So more conversations on that. Mark, you wanted to add something?
I just wanted to make a comment that, you know, there's so many different sources for data, and I think the challenge is how to bring all of this, you know, information from different sources together and for analysis. I think CDA, you guys did a lot of heads-up work with the participant characteristics, so there's tons of data, right?
Yes. So we have, that's what we had talked about previously, the merging of different data sets and what might, again, in the context of what's an interesting question that we want answered, how can we merge these data sets?
I would just add, just really quickly, I know we're over time, you know, the one idea that I had that I was really excited about was potentially pulling out these folks and looking at their utilization of the ER as compared to the kind of non-CBAS users.
Right.
And so that's when we started talking about this focus study, that was kind of like, oh, wow, can we really tease that out? And so the issue there is when we do our rates for the seniors and persons with disability, and so we kind of pull those folks out of the entire kind of Medi-Cal rates, we pull those people out, but we don't pull out the CBAS people out of the SPD rates, and so you kind of have those folks mixed in with those rates, and so you can't really do a fair comparison. So anyway, just some wrinkles, but to your point, it's, you know, what question are we trying to answer? I think from the get-go, that was kind of a great idea that we had as, hey, can we do this kind of comparison? Can we see that the data actually shows us that, you know, there is kind of this avoidance of the ER with CBAS participants.
The hard thing is finding a comparable control group.
Yeah.
So, I mean, it's...
Yeah.
I've noodled through all this stuff, so...
Yeah, a lot of us have to talk. Yeah. A lot of us have given a lot of time to this, so we'll work on this in coming months. But thank you, Oksana. I appreciate the update, and look forward to...
Thank you for the attention.
Yeah, definitely.
After 30 years.
Yeah.
It's more complicated than that.
Yes, it is.
Well, the other thing is, data is good. I mean, right, when you can pull it out, you can see how many people you're serving and what the array of diseases are that are being served and how that's working with some real data. I think when we kind of entered into all these projects, there was a lot of guessing going on around who we were serving and how many we were serving and what that looked like and what happened to them if. And so I think, you know, just being able to begin to look at data will give us ways that we can better analyze it.
Even just descriptive data.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah. Gotcha. I'm going to stop now and ask if do we have anybody commenting online or anybody who wants to just raise their voice and talk with us.
Jean Schneider had raised her hand a while ago, but I'm not sure.
You want to open up?
Are you there?
Somebody's trying to talk to us. Open up your line. Do we have everybody's lines open or just a few? Adam?
Everybody's lines are open. There's a bunch of people who have muted themselves.
Okay. So if you want to talk to us, everybody's lines are open, and